With data management, you can extract data from planning, stage it in data management, and then export it to a flat file. Then you can automate the process with EPM Automate. Starting in data management, select the Setup tab. First, I'll add a custom target application. The data you extract from planning is staged in our target application before exporting it to a flat file. For type, select Custom Application. In the Application Details section, enter an application name. On the Dimension Details tab, add a row for each planning dimension you want to export. The target dimension class is determined by the dimension type. The Data Table column name contains the name of the column in the Data Management Staging table. When you export, data is written to the file based on a predefined order, starting with account, then entity, then user-defined dimensions, and then amount. To make sure data management creates an output data file for the custom target application, set the Enable Export to File option to Yes. A file will be created in the Data Management Outbox folder of your server. The import format determines the integration mapping between the planning source and the target application. The name identifies the import format when you assign it to other configurations, such as location. Descriptions are optional. Select your source planning application. Select your target application. Drill URLs are not required for this integration. Always verify and save your entries. This is where you define the relationship between your source and target columns. For each row, select the source dimension that maps to the target dimension. Then you can choose to load data into a specific member by specifying a default in the expression text box. The location links the import format to the source and target systems. Enter a name. Descriptions are optional. Then select the import format you defined. The source and target systems are selected for you. Verify and save your entries. Let's talk about period mappings. You use period mappings to match period formats between the source and target system. Global mappings are shared by applications in your EPM system. The mappings that you create on the Application Mapping tab apply to the target application you select. Source mappings allow you to specify explicit and adjustment period mappings. Let's move on to our workflow and create data load mappings. Make sure you select the location you defined and the period you'll be importing from. You use data load mappings to derive the target members for each dimension based on source values. Create a mapping for each dimension you want to export. Options in the dimension drop-down list depend on the dimensions you configured in your import format. In this example, all source and target dimensions are mapped without modifications using the like mapping type. To run the data load process, you'll need to define a data load rule. First, verify that you have the correct location and POV selected. Enter a data load rule name. Descriptions are optional. Select your category, period mapping type, and source plan type. You can filter the data you want to import in the Source Filters section of the Source Options tab. In this example, I added a source filter for each dimension I'm importing. Click the Target Options tab. Verify that the Export to File option is enabled. Then specify a file name for the data file. Take note of the file name. We'll be using the file name when we automate the export process. Save your data load rule. When you execute the data load rule, make sure import from source and export to target are selected and verify your period selections. The status column displays the current state of the import and export process. Click refresh until you see a check mark. I'll navigate to the workbench to view the results. The data is staged in data management. I'll download the data file. Locate your process and scroll until you see the output file column. Click the download link. I'll save my data file to a local folder. The extracted data file contents are displayed. After executing your data load rule, you can use EPM Automate to rerun the export process. You also can automate the execution of the batch file using a scheduler. You can download EPM Automate from the Settings and Actions menu. My batch file is saved in the same folder as EPM Automate. It contains command lines used to complete the export process. You'll need the following: your Cloud EPM Planning URL and credentials, a dummy text file, create one in your local folder, your data load rule, start and end periods, the import mode, and export mode. Let's go over the sequence of commands. The first section logs you on to planning. The next section runs the data load rule with the periods, import and export mode, and dummy file. This section downloads the data file to my local folder. The last section tells you if the process completed successfully and then logs you out of planning. I'll run the batch file. The file is downloaded to the folder from which the utility was executed. The exported data file is displayed. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.